and welcome to Afterlife Adventures. Join me as we investigate the gruesome true crime story of the Pickaxe Murderer, Karla Faye Tucker. Now, let's get started. Karla Faye Tucker was born on November 18, 1959, in Houston, Texas. She was the youngest of three girls, and her parents' marriage was on the rocks, and they were starting divorce proceedings to end it. When Karla was 10 years old, she learned that she was the result of an extramarital affair. She started smoking at the age of 8, and by the age of 12 was drinking alcohol and was sexually active. She dropped out of school at 14 and started following rock groups as a groupie with her mother, Carolyn. She, like her mother, began prostituting herself for money. Her and her mother were traveling with the Allman Brothers Band, the Marshall Tucker Band, and the Eagles. At the age of 16, Karla married a mechanic named Stephen Griffith. Their marriage only lasted a brief amount of time. When Karla was in her 20s, she began hanging out with bikers, where she met a couple, Sean and Jerry Lynn Dean. They introduced Karla to a man named Daniel Ryan Garrett, who went by the name Danny. The two started dating even though Danny was 35 and Karla was 21 at the time. The four of them spent the weekend using drugs and partying. Karla and Danny decided that they were going to break into Jerry Dean's apartment that night because Karla had found a set of his keys that his wife, Sean Dean, had lost and Karla had found. Their intent was to steal Jerry's motorcycle that he had been restoring. They went to Jerry's apartment with a friend, James LeBrant, who reported that after arriving at Jerry's apartment, he went looking for his El Camino to steal while Karla and Danny entered the apartment. After entering Jerry's apartment, Karla and Danny entered Jerry's bedroom. Karla sat on top of Jerry. When Jerry tried to grab Karla by the upper arms to protect himself, Danny intervened and struck him numerous times in the back of the head with a ball-peen hammer he found on the bedroom floor. After hitting Dean, Danny left the room to remove motorcycle parts from the apartment. Tucker remained in the bedroom with him, where she stated he was making a gurgling sound that she couldn't stand hearing anymore. So to shut him up, she picked up a 3-foot pickaxe that was leaning against the bedroom wall and began striking him with the pickaxe. Garrett then re-entered the bedroom when he heard the noise and finished Dean off with a final blow to the chest. Garrett left Karla in the bedroom again and continued to load motorcycle parts into his Ford Ranchero. While Karla was in the bedroom, she noticed a woman hiding under the bed. The woman was Deborah Ruth Thornton, who had argued with her husband the day before and had gone to a party with Jerry Dean and wound up spending the night with him. Karla struck Deborah in the shoulder with the pickaxe, but only grazed her shoulder. The two women began to struggle, but Garrett returned and separated the two women. Karla proceeded to hit Deborah repeatedly with the pickaxe until the pickaxe embedded into her heart. Tucker later told people she had multiple orgasms with each blow of the pickaxe. The following day, one of Dean's co-workers showed up at the apartment looking for a ride to work when he discovered the bodies of the victims. Tucker and Garrett were arrested for the murders 5 weeks after they occurred. In September of 1983, Garrett and Tucker were indicted for the murders and tried separately. Karla was charged with both murders of Dean and Thornton, but the murder charges for Thornton were dropped because Karla testified against Garrett. He was not charged for Deborah Thornton's murder either. While in prison, Karla claimed that she read a Bible and prayed for forgiveness, wanting to become a Christian. Tucker and Garrett were both sentenced to death in 1984. Garrett passed away from liver disease in 1993 while awaiting his execution. Karla asked that her life be spared because she was on drugs at the time of the murders, and they never would have happened if she wasn't under the influence at the time of the murders. Her plea drew support from many people. The leaders of the American conservatism, Newt Gingrich, Pope John Paul II, and even Deborah Thornton's brother, Ronald Carlson. Hours before her execution, Texas Governor George W. Bush refused the 11th hour appeal to block her execution. On February 2, 1998, Karla was taken from the Gatesville Unity in Texas to the Huntsville Unit in Texas. Karla selected four people to watch her execution: her sister Carrie, her spouse Dana Brown, a close friend Jackie Onken, and Ronald Carlson. Deborah Thornton's husband, son, and stepdaughter were witnesses to the execution. Karla's last words to the Thornton family were, "I am so sorry. I hope God will give you peace with this." Karla was executed by lethal injection on February 3, 1998. She is buried at the Forest Park Lawndale Cemetery in Houston, Texas. Karla Faye Tucker was the first woman executed in the state of Texas in over 135 years. If you enjoyed this video from our series, Women Executed on Death Row, and would like to see more videos from our True Crime series, please subscribe, like, and hit the notification buttons for more videos. Thanks for watching.